and we're going to do the French braid, see, but we're only going to take hair from one side. So you're going to kind of braid so we'll do it really quick. I'll just show you really quick how it's going to look. And the tighter you hold the braid, I mean, you guys are going to take some time for you guys to learn. When you guys first do, your braid's going to start up here, and it's going to start
head in the bucket for that.
He's like, what?
Would you like, could you use a regular stool by
the way? You're going to basically pull to this side. You're pulling. Actually, when you look at it, so when you pull it, the more if you pull down this way, then it's, your braid is just going to drift down. You kind of want to be on your horse like this. And then you pull towards their withers. That's how you do it. So you start here, and you take your three strands of your braid, like you normally do. And when I get down here, you guys will be able to see better. I'm going to take three braids here, as you can see. And I've learned a way to do it the other way. So you see that? And then since the hair is in the left hand here, this one you're supposed to take, only take, the only hair you have to take is on the left side. You just want to get to the left side here. This is where you take some hair, add it to the third strand, and now you have three new strands. One fold over, now you have a new strand here to add more hair. You just keep adding hair to the left hand every time it goes over one. And then what you do is, when you pull, you always pull this way, and then like I'm holding the tightness, you always want to pull like almost over here this way or towards the withers, and that way it stays on top of the crest. So we just want to take an equal amount, and it may take you a while to learn how to take an equal amount each time.
But we have verses for you to practice on every day.
Then I'm going to tell you that. That's the only reason.
Practice every day.
I trained my mare every other day for 5 years. Because I tell you, by the time she got a yearling, I was a penny. And she didn't even have one.
And I don't care if every horse has a French braid.
So I see how I'm kind of bringing my hand over here. This is where I'm grabbing the bolt this way. The one's over. Now I have two strands. I'm more particular and more careful.
Okay, we'll get down here and I'll show you guys.
beautiful mane tonight.
Otherwise, I do have an appointment in the afternoon.
Okay, how good is that?
I do have an appointment in the afternoon, but I can
see it. And you guys can go in. What's nice about this braid since it's so tight, you guys can go in and you'll kind of see it. The braid will start to kind of go like, you know, like a little S-curve, maybe with some place. So actually, if you kind of go the other way, it retightens in certain spots and loosens in other spots. Because it's so tight that you can actually even it out. You can see I'm already evening it up. This side kind of messed up here. I didn't grab it so well, but that's okay. We can tuck that back. But so this. So. So we have our three strands here. You guys can go over here a little bit closer together when I come over here. So just maybe here are the straight three strands I have right now. I'm gonna cross them over one. This one that I just put hair on, this one's all the way to the left here. I just put hair onto that from the mane, bringing that around. Now I have a new left strand. This one comes over. Now you grab the hair, pull it that way. Do a crossover once. We're going to go one and two. That's a full crossover. Now I have a new strand to add left hair to. You just keep adding left hair to that strand. One full turnover back to here. One full turnover. It's kind of you're doing the one, two, then on the third one is when you take the hair. So just when you're just, it's a regular braid, you're just adding hair to the left strand. So once the left strand goes away and the new left strand comes, take hair to that left strand. When that one goes away, the new one comes, put hair on that left strand. And then the tighter you pull that hair, those two, see like these two there strands? That's going to make the braid nicer. And so here I am going to put the two together. So basically what you're doing is when you take that new hair, you're scrunching with the two strands together. You're scrunching the strand with the new hair together as tight as you can. Pull it to make it one strand as hard as you can. And then weave that in with the next one. So that's what we're doing. So we're just taking it and we're weaving it into the next one. Okay, I'm going to take more hair. Now it's going to start getting easier down here because it's pressed thin. So it's not as just like I was grabbing this whole wide thing. So here's my three strands. This one I just added hair to. Do you see how it's like all this one here? Now you'll see once I'm going to do a crossover. This is kind of confusing. Now I have a new left strand, but just see how it's so far away from this hair. When you take this hair together, you want to, this is where you're tight. You combine them together. See how I have two separate ones? This original strand with extra hair. You scrunch them together as hard as you can. Pull. Two turnovers. One pull, and then there is another one. So there's a gap. Pull those two together. Tighten. Around. Another turnover. So see that gap that happens? And then you grab the hair there. Make it one strand. Turnover. I mean, it took me a year to get the hair. And then to the point where I can literally just be talking and get grabbing stuff.
Yeah.
And the thing is, it's usually these straight hairs. Usually, I don't know how you guys do, but usually, if you can't braid it in, I'll cut them off because they usually taste too small. But you want to go all the way down on the way there. Then, when you're done, you have no more hair to grab. Just do a regular braid. Finish up. Down with a regular braid. And the way I usually do it, there's a couple different ways. But I'll try to get this as down as far as I can into the braid. Hopefully it doesn't shake. If you let go now,
oh my gosh,
it's all connected. But what's nice, it's so tight. So then the most essential thing is this right here comes out, it's a full braid. But if this stays in, you're awesome. So one braid, one band for me. And I'm going to just make this as tight as possible. Because this holds the rest of it. And he can stretch, he can do it. It may not be too comfortable for him to stretch as much, but he'll stretch, he'll be able to stretch. So we're going to do this, and the way I do it at the end is I try to get the band all the way to the tight as it's going to get, and I break it. Alright, so I'm going to get to, you know, basically to the point where it's going to be as tight as I can be. I can't, like, barely get it around one more time. And I do the fold over, so we take this end out of here without having to snip it off. Some people snip it off, which I don't. A little too tight here. Need another rubber band.
I think
another rubber band.
You have another rubber band?
No, she got one. Oh. She's on my third one already. So I'll take it easy on this. So I'm going to get to this. And then what I do is before, I don't let it go all the way around. But normally I would take and pull this through. Instead of pulling it through, I'll just let it hold it. So then it kind of brings it back out. And that way your end is a little bit, now his end's a little bit long. I just can't braid it out anymore. I might snip a little bit here if that's the way I do it. That way this little thing doesn't stick here. But then what I do is I go and I take it. And the reason I'll show you why you want to probably snip this part off since it won't braid anymore is...
control the thunder.
So he
rubber bands?
Oh, see,
this is the cleanest thing to do. Some people actually go back in and pull it into the braid. But I found out that it can you can damage the rest of the braid if you do it that way. So this, we're just gonna, this is going to be a little bit not as neat as I'd like it to be because I have a strand sticking out. Just kind of pull it under one. You just keep holding it so it's so tight. It's a little ball, and then you kind of put your band here. This is as tight as you can get. I mean, and then just to be safe, I would probably put two or three more bands in here just to hold it because then it'll flatten it out. But once you put a saddle pad on here, you're not going to see it. But that's it. That's the whole way. Then you can go in and you can go tweak it. And it's nice. It's so tight that you can start putting flowers and ribbon and everything in here if you really want to do it. But this is how you braid the forelock directly. If you don't braid the forelock in, you just leave the forelock in and then you strip.
Wow.
How does that look?
Beautiful.
Bravo.
So now with this one, he'll be able to run around. And
I'm going to come over and get a little
problem here, but...